ran out of fuel. I don't know. I'm worried, though.
How far can she turn her head?
Yeah, bye.
Only employees of
I can't imagine what Eric's going through right now. Sure thing. Take a look.
Okay. It's like she's gonna turn her head all the way around. Notes? Oh, I didn't. I just clicked. I want to look at it. Okay, we bought Dover Beach, I guess. Oh, she's got all these elements and such. One weapon. One spacesuit. Two helmets. Aid. So I don't think she has digipicks. I think those fall under miscellaneous. Bastoris Laboratories. Elbow grease gear. Ore breaker outfit and engineering outfit.
Good luck out there.
Thank you. I thought that was a safe. So I was trying to open the safe and I blew up the residential section. Jane's big plan. Oh, I can just take that. Jane Weller. Jane's Goods. Step 1. Establish Jane's Goods as an actual storefront. Ozzy said I can move into his space next to the community center as soon as he closes up to move. He's even be giving his last few months' rent. Score! Step 2. Save up for a cargo ship. I made contact with another junk dealer who said he's always got some leads. As soon as I make enough, I'm going to buy one and hire a pilot. It'll save me tons of money in the long run and allow me to expand my inventory. Step 3. Buy a fleet of ships. Set up shops in other communities. There's always going to be a need for cheap secondhand goods and other stuff. Step 4. Universal domination. Wahahaha. Just kidding. Well, I stole her notes. I don't know how she can be successful now. Oh, what's this book I just bought, though? Dover Beach. Ah, love, let us be true to one another, for this world, which seems to lie before us like a land of dreams, so various, so beautiful, so new, hath really neither joy, nor love, nor light, nor certitude, nor peace, nor help for pain, and we are here as on a darkling plain, swept with confused alarms of struggle and flight, where ignorant armies clash by night. So reads the final stanza of Matthew Arnold's stirring poem, Dover Beach. They have a whole book just for this one poem. Should be called Dover Beach and Other Poems. Alright, so we got a lot of people in here.
Faith in the greatness and ingenuity of the human spirit is what helped us spread among the stars.
Maybe it's my crowd of people.
If you know anyone in need of food or shelter,
horse?
Please send them my way. The Sanctum Universum will provide.
Okay. I'll talk to these people. I'll talk to Horace anyway. But maybe this is what's causing the stuttering, at least sometimes. Crowd density. Turn it low? I hate for it to be on low. I was waiting to see if some of these people can just disappear.
I have a pen pal in New Atlantis. We've never met in person, but she's still one of my best friends.
Oh, I have a letter from her. You're Haddie.
20 years ago, I moved to Sidonia on a whim. Never thought I'd stay for as long as I have.
What brings you to the community center?
Not to get all sappy, but I lost a son in the war. It's been 20 years, but it still makes my brain a bit swirly thinking about it. Just never got to say goodbye, you know? That bugs me. So I come here to try and get peace.
What do you think of the caretakers here?
Joy and Horace? I think they get along well enough. Sure, they argue, but that's a good thing.
Joy and Horace.
Disagreement's healthy. What good are your beliefs if you never have to defend them?
Are we talking about you? So Haddie asked me to deliver this letter to you. Surprise.
Still doing things by hand, huh? I keep telling her, she needs to act her age, not the stone one. But some people think being difficult builds character. Oh well. Let's see what she wrote. I hope this doesn't mean...
Did I read the letter? Said she was gonna die soon, like she had like weeks to live or something. Yeah, I read the letter and I'm sorry.
I appreciate it. Without you bringing it here, I would have never known. I need to go see her. If she's really on death's door, then this could be my only chance. Thank you for bringing me this.
Head D to New Atlantis.
I need to go see my friend.
Okay. I'll leave you to get on with that.
How's it going?
Oh, just peachy.
Phew, what a long day.
Yeah.
There are many stories and films about demons, ghosts, and other entities on Mars. No wonder people here do not take religion seriously anymore.
Oh, they don't?
Greetings, my child. Is there any assistance the Sanctum Universum can offer you?
No, I don't need anything, just wanted to talk.
Very well. I would be happy to take the time to speak with another child of God. Perhaps you would like to hear more about our benevolent creator.
We can stay and listen if you like. I find theological discussions to be quite interesting.
The Sanctum Universum will always be available to you, if you wish to know more.
Do you wish to know more? Well, I think people drive their own fate and morality, not some sort of non-existent mystical creator. That's like kind of offensive to say that, but...
While I must disagree, I won't try to change your mind. You are welcome to go alone in your spiritual journey and make your own discoveries.
Oh, thanks.
But if you ever find yourself lost and need some guidance, please know that I am always available should you be interested in a different path.
What do you do here?
I help run this community center along with my associate, Joy. People from all walks of life are always welcome to come here and share this space for whatever purpose they need. I am also here to assist those seeking faith in God under the Sanctum Universum as we lack a true spiritual center here on Mars.
What can you tell me about your beliefs?
In its simplest form, Sanctum Universum believes that God has given us the ability to manipulate the heavens so that He may lead us to Him.
What was that?
As such, we accept those from all the faiths of old, provided they seek faith in the Almighty Creator.
I think I'm possessed. I think that entity possessed me. Can you perform an exorcism? Mouse wheel doesn't seem to work.
Patience is a virtue I am familiar with.
Because I'm having trouble with my mouse wheel. If God brought us to the stars, why stop there and not lead us to Him directly?
Ah, because to truly follow the teachings of our Lord and Creator, you must still have faith. Were He to simply lead us to Him directly, it would defeat the purpose. You see, our mortal journey is still an important part of the human experience. We must learn and grow in our lives. Only then can we prove we are worthy of joining Him in the hereafter.
Okay. You mentioned something about offering assistance to those in need.
We will always offer assistance to anyone who needs it, regardless if they choose to follow our faith. One is not conditional upon the other. We would never turn someone in need away. and we will happily serve those of any level of need.
What need do you offer? Can I get financial assistance?
Unfortunately, that is not the sort of assistance we can deliver. Except in rare circumstances where we can help organize a fundraiser.
Someone keeps pushing me. Can you offer me some spiritual guidance?
Happily. God is wonderful and works in mysterious ways. You may feel down on your luck, but rest assured, he has a plan for you.
Okay. Can I get a hot meal?
Certainly. We don't currently have the soup kitchen open, but when we do, you are more than welcome to join us.
Do you have a safe place where I can sleep?
You may feel free to use one of the community sleep pods, so long as it is unoccupied. We only ask that you take good care to leave it in the same state you find it in.
I was going to destroy it after. I'd be gracious for anything you have to offer. Just curious what else you may offer.
Certainly. Take this, and may God be with you.
What's this? Oh, you give me centimeat. Nice. Well, thank you.
Have a blessed day.
Have a spiffy day. The Orchid Merchant. Launch Point Mars. An excerpt from the non-fiction book Launch Point Mars about Mars' early role in spaceflight. Along with the abundance of raw resources, the lower gravity, and the existence of the Cydonia colony base made Mars an ideal location for launching new ships deeper into the Sol system. For many years, the famous Mars launch pad was used for this purpose, and many scientific discoveries took place as a result. Humanity built outposts on numerous moons under the light of Sol. Of course, when new grav drive technology came online, thanks to the likes of companies like Nova Galactic and Deimos Star Yards, technological advances made constructing and launching ships from orbit a much better prospect. The Mars launch pad transitioned to a means of transporting resources and workers to the Star Yard in orbit. As ship designs began reintegrating takeoff and landing systems, the Mars launch pad became less and less relevant. It wasn't long before the project was quietly abandoned, yet it stands as a monument to the times, even today. The latest password is password 02 with caps mixed in. But I can't use that computer. I've read The Orchid Merchant before.
Never forget, there's nothing humanity can accomplish through science and working hand in hand with one another.
They were talking at you when you were looking at us.
Hi. Why, hello there. What can I help you with? Have you come to seek assistance from the House of Enlightenment?
Yes, financial. But I was turned down for that. The House of Enlightenment? Whatever do you mean?
Yes, the Enlightened serve as a community-centric institution, much like a traditional church, but without religious faith. For it's the community and faith in one another, which is important, not adherence to a particular religious dogma.
Okay. What kind of assistance do you offer?
We're here to serve the Cydonia community in many ways.
Cydonia?
While we don't have a belief in a greater power, we have faith in humanity that people will always strive to better the human race. As a community, we come together to help those in need. Food, shelter, basic amenities. We'll provide because that's what people do for one another.
All right, well, I don't think I need anything right now, so why?
We'll always be here if you need something, or just want to meet people. Actually, before you go,
oops.
Would you mind helping me out with something?
Damn it, almost got away.
I was debating with my dear friend Horace, and would like an outside opinion.
He's your friend?
He believes that faith in a higher power is what inspires more people to be good.
Well, I think you're married.
I say that more people do good without any promise of divine reward or retribution. What do you think?
It's an interesting thing because I forget who it was. It might have been George Carlin. It might have even been Penn from Penn and Teller. I'm not getting into a religious debate, guys, whether it exists one way or the other, but how many people would do bad things, right, if religion was the only thing stopping them? Like, I really want to kill this guy, but I'll go to hell. I can't be forgiven for that, taking another life, so I have to let him live. So I wonder how many people like that are out there. And, yeah, maybe religion is a good thing to stop at least that section of people from doing bad things. Both are right. It doesn't actually matter what inspires more good.
That's an interesting perspective. Thank you. I guess when you get down to it, as long as people are good to each other, it doesn't matter what drives them to be good. I'll be sure to share that with Horace.
What? You had a quest for me.
Be advised.
Oh. I'm getting ready for this.
I wish there was something more to do around here. Drinking gets old.
What's that? I couldn't hear you. Done.
Just passing through or here to stay?
Yes. Oh, they've got all stuff for people here. Tranquility.
It's not easy living in Cydonia.
Yeah, some of these people here say Cydonia. Orange juice.
Cydonia's not so bad. Honest work, good pay. I can't complain.
Okay, shut up.
What a day, huh?
You watching the show? Whoops. Sorry, didn't mean to show off. Can you pick things up?
A reminder that particle detonation can occur.
It's a steal anyway, I'll end up messing things up. I want to turn these.
Before you say anything, no. Mars is nothing like Earth. Heck, even Earth is nothing like what Earth used to be.
I wasn't going to say anything.
I swear that warning klaxon still startles me every time.
Not as much as the explosion. What's up here? Besides more stairs. Oh, is this another one of those ultra impregnable? Oh no, this goes out. Let me take a peek out there. I know there's different entrances, but what if there's a place that I can only get through? Only get two, even though it's the central hub, from here, right? No, I've been out here. Oops. That was a bad stutter. Okay. More stutters. Okay, this is all.
I need to go see my friend.
We're done here. Go see her. are you waiting around for? Okay, so what's this? Oh, that's an elevator, so no way. So the only place we haven't seen is in there, in the Lux apartments, and then I came in there.
Crime's at an all-time low around Sidonia. Let's keep it that way.
Huh. I could bash your face in, that would be crime, right? Clean up after yourself. I don't know if we're ever gonna see anyone sitting at one of these when we open it. Alright.
Ever been to Aquila? Mm. Those security uniforms are way cooler than anything we've got.
Yeah, you gotta upgrade that stuff. UC Marine Barracks.
Always be ready for anything.
Is that why training's important?
Can't wait to get shipped off to another base.
Coolio. UC Defense Manual 03 slightly increases magazine size and weapon bash critical chance for all Allied armaments guns. Sweet. And I want that sushi. A sealed container. Containing what?
This place reminds me of my UC Navy training barracks. Cold, cramped, and offensive.
This is not a steal, this sealed container. That might be a quest item, maybe. We can find out. I know this is complete metagaming here. Wait, that's not inventory. So, wait, there's a space for... Does that mean... That just means it's new, right? Oh. It may or may not be a quest item. But just in case it is, I have it. Looking right at me. Yeah, just practicing my calisthenics. Nothing to see here. Hippolyta. What's a Hippolyta? Reminds me, I have a skill to increase. And I could try to get into one of those computers because the password was right there. As long as somebody's not there. And I came back when there was no one there, but I forgot about it. Yeah, I'll steal an empty toilet paper tube. The Hippolyta. Now I'm very well seen. Can you stop looking at me? Getting in the middle of, in the way of me stealing stuff. perimeter secure. You're guarding the barracks? Is that your duty?
I don't care what anyone says. This is still a tough assignment.
Yeah, staring at me is really hard.
Why'd I have to be stationed on Mars of all places?
Because they don't like you. You're leaving? I got a digipick. Did I look in these? He wasn't looking. I just want to know what a Hippolyta is. What did I do? No. I took something. Did I take the Hippolyta?
Red devils used to train here on Mars.
Okay, I'm trying to do something. Stop talking to me. I'm over here now. Goodbye. I guess I took it. Yeah, I took it. Alright. I don't know what's going on then. Where's status? I have an affliction. Oh! That's what the Hippolyta does. Oh, I wasted it. 20% persuasion chance. Just under 5 minutes. Is that just the default thing it says? Because it says I have a condition. I mean, this is a good condition.
Still clear.
All clear. Not so much back here.
Tough it out on Mars. Tough it out anywhere.
Okay. Guess so. Alright. I was about to say, am I done with the residential area, but no, we've still got the deluxe apartments.
Do you ever get songs stuck in your head?
Oh.
Sometimes I have to make up my own songs just to get rid of them.
It's gonna explode again. I'm just gonna hang out here with you. I'm supposed to talk to her. That's an activity. Speak with Renee.
Grown-ups are always so grumpy.
Yeah, I didn't realize Renee is a kid. But supposedly she put me in a really good mood or something.
Hi, I'm Renee, and I'm so bored.
Don't hit your head.
My mom and dad said not to talk to people I don't know, so I thought maybe I could talk to you, and then I know you, and I won't be so bored.
Well, it's a good thing I started talking to you, because you didn't initiate this conversation. Can't argue with that logic. Sure, we can talk. I'm Cora.
See? Now we're friends! And my parents can't say I'm not allowed to talk to you!
Not your age,
though. Anyway, what do you want to talk about?
Murder. Do you like living in Sidonia?
It's okay, I guess. It's better than living outside, because Mars can't support life outside and I'd die.
Well, yeah.
But maybe it would be nice to live on another planet someday. I think I used to when I was a real little kid. And sometimes my mom and dad would take me to visit my grandma and grandpa in New Atlantis.
Hmm. I wonder if I've met them. Are there lots of other kids your age to play with around here? I'm thinking not.
Not really. I mean, there's Taiye. He's a good friend. But he's also one of my only friends.
Taizonde.
There aren't many kids on Mars, because my mom says that this is really only a place where people come to work hard jobs for a little while. But I wish there were more kids, because it gets boring. Like, when Taiye is busy and my mom and dad are off working.
Right. Well, there can't be much for kids to do around here.
I like to play with Taiye sometimes. We come up with lots of games to play. Sometimes we listen to music or watch shows. But when he's not around, I like to draw. Sometimes I draw things and give them to people, since they're so mopey all the time. It makes them smile.
Hmm.
Actually, want to help me? I just drew these great pictures of Space Frog, but I can't go out right now. Can you help put them up for me?
Space Frog? What's a Space Frog?
It's Space Frog from outer space. And he's a little frog character that I made up.
Oh, okay.
I've never seen a real frog before, but I've seen pictures. Anyway, he lives in space and goes around to different planets helping people who are sad or need help. He's great.
So he's like you, just in frog form. Are your parents okay with this?
Yeah, they've let me do it before. But they're working, so they can't help me do it, and they don't let me leave the condos without them. They say it's for my safety. But my friend Taya's mom sometimes lets him go out without her.
So I guess this is activities you get sometimes. Somebody will just tell you to talk to somebody, and then it turns into a quest. It's pretty interesting. Does that actually help people?
My mom says it does. She says her work friends like my drawings because they make them smile. She says it's because there aren't many kids here, and lots of people miss having kids around. Or it reminds them of their families.
Bolita wore off. I wasted that, oh well. At least they can't be stolen away from me, taken away from me as contraband. Sure, I'd love to, just tell me where to put them.
You will? Thank you! People are gonna be so happy! Here's a bunch of copies of the Space Frog drawing I made. You can post them in places where you think people will see them. Thank you so much!
What do I have a feeling this is gonna cause problems?
Just put the pictures up where you think lots of people are going to see them.
Alright, 0 of 6 Space Frog drawings.
Bye!
Bye!